This season, it's pretty. The first episode, in fact, let's just go right to that.
Yeah.
Of this season, is something, a story that I've heard, and it is true.
This is a true story. So, Hall of Fame baseball player Wade Boggs.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, played in Boston, played
Amazing.
Here in New York.
Third baseman.
Yeah. Did a stint in Tampa.
Yeah.
For the Tampa fans.
No, we had him here when he was a Yankee. Do you remember when he got on the horse after the World Series?
No, I remember it because.
Yeah. That's how cool this dude is, man. He just jumps on a horse with a cop. He's like, let's go, buddy.
I remember my friend's father, like a diehard Boston fan, like having a heart attack. Just like, what are you doing, Boggsy? You know, get off the horse!
He doesn't care. He's Wade Boggs.
I got nothing against it.
Anyway,
he was famous for baseball. He was also famous for the amount of beer he could drink.
I heard these stories.
Yeah, so supposedly when they would have these cross-country flights, he would drink on average 40 to 50, some say 70 beers. Like, he's got like
From L.A. to New York type of thing?
Yeah.
Like a six-hour flight?
There was like a layover somewhere in North Dakota. And then, I don't know. So our characters
beers.
Are trying to break that record in the episode.
The first episode, you guys are all going to fly and see if you can break the record.
Yeah, and then see if we can go hit a baseball the next day. Because not only would he drink 70 beers, but then he'd go like 3 for 4.
The next day, he's a magician, this guy.
No, he is. He's got like a hot dog eating stomach, but for beer.
I know what you mean. Yeah,
the gang gets on a plane and they try to break the record. And of course, you know, they're debaucherous and they don't
Your
quite
character
do
starts
it.
To hallucinate.
I hallucinate and actually start speaking to Wade Boggs. And
you got the real Wade Boggs to come on the show.
Yeah, we reached out to him. You know, we're like, is he going to be okay with this? And he's like, oh, I'll do it. You
know? How was he?
Oh, he was great. He was great. Although, I'm pretty sure he was drinking actual beer when we were filming, because we all had prop beer, and then I noticed at one point, he's drinking now. Like, he's you know, he's an alcoholic.
No.
But highly functioning. Highly functioning.
Not true,
No. He's a good sport.
Why not? He should do it. Yeah, I mean, if he can handle 70 beers, I mean.
Well, he told me that the actual number, he's like, he pulled me aside, he's like, Charlie, really? It was 107. Yeah, so how's that possible, right?
6 hours, I mean, I should get Jeff Musial here for the math, but 6 hours to drink 100, I don't even know if they have them on planes.
Not 6 hours, so he would come, you know, to the airport about 12 deep, and then he'd be on the plane and just firing them back.
Yeah.
And then they'd have the layover, and then they get there, and then they would go out that night, you know, and then he'd hit third and hit 2 doubles. And
good gosh, that's an amazing man.
And so it makes for a good episode.
107 beers.
107.
Man, Wade Boggs. Yeah. We have a clip. Here's Charlie Day and Wade Boggs in the season premiere of It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. Take a look at this.
Hello, Charlie.
Oh! You're the ghost of Wade Boggs.
I'm not a ghost, Charlie. You're just hallucinating. You had over 30 beers, dude.
You did? Nice, man.
You know your friend Mac is right.
Oh, yeah?
I didn't win 5 batting titles because it was fun.
Right.
I won it because I wanted to be the best. Do you see what I'm saying?
Nah, not really, man.
There's nothing more fun than winning. So come on, drink up. I'll have one with you.
Nice. Yeah. Let's do it,
All
Boggs.
Right.
Let's drink.
Cheers.
Charlie Day, Wade Boggs, Always Sunny in Philadelphia.